Well, when you came along with the Mars trilogy, there were a couple of things that were unique at the time. One was Mars was not hip then. It's insanely hip now. And you were writing a pretty leftist economic model onto basically how the geoengineering, the terraforming of Mars would play out. Is that an accurate statement?
Yeah, that's right.
And in your mind, where you're doing that, is that's how you could realistically imagine Mars actually being terraformed, or this was at last a chance, a platform to play out some of your leftist fantasies?
Well, maybe more the latter. When I was writing the Mars books, it was the Viking data. The Viking data came in 76, and they gave us a Mars that was a million times more detailed than what we had before that, Mariner and Viking. It took a while to assimilate for science fiction writers and say, well, what have we got here? And then it was Sagan and his crowd that said, if you were interested in terraforming and wanted a planet to do it, Mars is as good as it gets. We'll never find a place that is more close to being terraformable, and they began to model it. So I was the lucky recipient of that. When I began to write novels, and I saw that Mars would be a great place to backpack, and it resembled the High Sierra, which it didn't, but in Green Mars and Blue Mars, it does.
Nevada so, resembles, right?
It was, yeah, it goes like from the Ruby Range in Nevada to the Sierra to the Coastal Range over the trilogy. It was something I wanted to do. And then the leftist ideas was just my hippie California, Gary Snyder, New Age, Buddhist,
right.
You know the drill, here I am.
Gary was a red diaper baby, he grew up with it, did you?
No, I grew up in Orange County to a blue diaper baby. Whatever, it was not a political household, it was a technical and pseudo-apolitical household.
Pseudo-apolitical household is a concept.
Well, I think that the American technical class would say, happens too often, that, well, I'm just into technical stuff, I transcend politics, or politics is the grubby stuff and science is the clean stuff, and they try to make an artificial distinction between the two.
So are you basically turning against that, or did somebody get to you with a more interesting and persuasive frame?
It was a combination of Snyder, Frederick Jameson, Ursula Le Guin, and the science fiction community itself. I was very lucky in my teachers. All three of those were teachers of mine at different times in my life. Jameson was my thesis advisor, and he told me to write about Philip K. Dick, the greatest living American writer, at which my jaw dropped. I had only read Galactic Pot Healer, and I was looking at this professor thinking, you've got to be kidding me. But I went ahead and I read Phil Dick on Fred Jameson's behalf, and then Gary was teaching poetry at Davis when I was there, and so I took classes from him.
Right.
And Ursula came down to UCSD and taught science fiction writing at UCSD, so I'm thinking, just do what they tell you.
Yeah.
Have fun.